As of July 26 of 2022, SpaceX had already surpassed their previous annual record with 32 launches. On July 22nd, SpaceX launched its 32nd Falcon 9 mission of the year successfully. That is sufficient to surpass its previous mark for orbital launches in a calendar year. Welcome to Techmo. In today's video, we will talk about SpaceX's new launch record. SpaceX successfully launched its 32nd Falcon 9 mission for 2022. This means that the company has officially broken its own record for the most orbital launches in 1 year. Since it's only July, the year still has time to break that record. SpaceX has steadily increased the number of times it launches each year, except in 2019, when it slowed down. In 2021, the company did 31 launches, which was the most it had ever done. This also made SpaceX the most successful US launch company to date right away. At the start of 2022, SpaceX has a very ambitious plan to launch 52 missions. NASA Safety Advisory Panel told the public about the number in January, along with a warning that SpaceX must keep safety in mind as the pace picks up. Sandy Magnus, a former NASA astronaut and member of NASA Space Safety Advisory Committee, said at the January meeting, "NASA and SpaceX must be careful in 2022 so that they don't become victims of their own success. There is still a significant portion of this year to go, but so far, SpaceX has been able to maintain its timetable, and each of the company's missions that have been carried out this year have been successful." Ironically, SpaceX intended to carry out the launch of the missions on Thursday, but they called off the countdown when the abortion began less than a minute before the launch was scheduled to occur. This was an extremely unusual event for SpaceX, which had not been forced to halt the countdown due to a technical issue for several months at that point. After what seemed like an endless countdown, the business was finally allowed to launch today. A significant contributor to the company's hectic launch schedule is the fact that SpaceX is the company's primary customer for the majority of its missions planned for this year. Up to 53 satellites can be placed into orbit simultaneously during one of these launches, which are used by the business to bring the expansive Starlink constellation online from space, although numbers vary from launch to launch. The voyage, which originated from the Vandenberg Space Force Base in California, was responsible for the addition of 46 Starlink satellites. At this very moment, the corporation has close to 2,600 Starlink satellites operating in space. Even in the event that SpaceX was unable to launch Starlink, the business would still have a significant amount of work to complete. Dragon capsules are being delivered to the International Space Station by SpaceX in collaboration with NASA. These capsules transport both humans and their belongings. The business conducts what are known as carrier missions, in which a number of smaller satellites are launched into space simultaneously. All of this, in addition to the fact that SpaceX has commercial customers and performs launches for the Department of Defense, results in a workforce that is extremely busy. The majority of the Falcon 9 rockets that SpaceX has launched so far this year have already been put to use. The business is continuing to work on bringing its rockets back to Earth and reusing them. In addition, SpaceX is solely working on the Block 5 version of the Falcon 9 rocket, which is intended to be deployed on several locations over its service life. The rocket launched today successfully landed on one of SpaceX's unmanned ships after it completed its mission. This marks the 125th time that the firm's Falcon 9 rocket has successfully landed after a space mission. The goal of SpaceX's Starlink constellation is to make high-speed broadband internet available to every person on the planet. This will be accomplished through the utilization of a network of 42,000 satellites in low Earth orbit. As a direct result of the launch that took place on Friday, SpaceX reported on Twitter that the Starlink service is now accessible in a total of 36 countries. Luxembourg, St. Martin, and St. Bartholomew are some of the new countries that have been recognized. In addition, on Sunday, the business carried out a launch that successfully placed an additional 53 Starlink satellites into orbit, bringing the total number of successful launches in a row by SpaceX to a staggering 2022 total. There are approximately 2,660 operational satellites that make up the constellation at the moment. The company has been around since 2002 and is a major player in the commercial space business. In addition to breaking the launch record, SpaceX hopes to reach another important milestone this year: the first orbital test of the company's huge Starship rocket, which is currently being tested in Boca Chica, Texas. SpaceX has stepped up its launch schedule this year, sending up a variety of payloads, such as its Starlink satellites, crew and cargo missions for NASA, missions for the Department of Defense, and commercial satellites. As of Monday, the Falcon 9 rocket has lifted nearly 300,000 kilograms into low Earth orbit every 6.4 days this year. This is a lot more than every country and business in the world put together. This week, two more Starlink games are likely to come out. SpaceX has also kept pushing the limits of how things can be used again. In the last month, the company's 13th flight had three different first stages. Officials at SpaceX say that they have learned enough about reusing these first stage cores that for now, there doesn't seem to be any problems that would stop them from flying many more missions each. To get a sense of how often this happens, think about the number of flights made by United Launch Alliance, SpaceX's main US-based competitor. From March 19th of 2017 until now, ULA has launched 31 rockets from its Delta and Atlas fleets. That means that one launch happens every 64 days. In other words, SpaceX is now launching 10 rockets for every one that its main US competitor launches. During this time, both companies have been successful 100% of the time. The rules of this competition will change over the next few years. ULA's new heavy lift Vulcan rocket will be launched soon, probably in the first half of 2023, with a long launch manifest that includes both institutional customers and Amazon's Project Kuiper. The company's cadence should increase by a lot. This is likely to happen around the middle of the 2020s, as ULA ramps up its operations and Vulcan production. Additionally, SpaceX is making headway with the development of its Starship rocket for the next generation. There is a good chance that a series of test flights for this super heavy lift rocket will get underway in South Texas within the next 6 months. Nevertheless, SpaceX is preparing to launch Starship along with its super heavy rocket from its facilities in Florida. At the Launch Complex 39A location at Kennedy Space Center, the corporation has recently completed the assembly of numerous components of an orbital launch tower in order to accomplish this goal. Before NASA's cargo flight on Friday, Trevor Mullman was able to shoot a zoomable panorama of the launch tower for ARS as he was putting up a remote camera in preparation for the launch. South Texas and Florida have both been mentioned as possible launch locations for SpaceX's Starship, although the company has not confirmed either option. However, it is appearing more and more likely that the business will conduct test flights of Starship in Texas and would only travel to the Florida range when it is certain that the vehicle functions effectively. This makes logical sense, given that numerous high-value assets, including those belonging to NASA, the Department of Defense, the National Reconnaissance Office, and other launch businesses, are all located in Florida. So that's all for today's video. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up, and if you want to watch more videos like this one, hit the subscribe button and turn on the notifications so that you will always be notified.